Good morning, students. In this class, we will learn about the electric furnace. In the last class, we have learned about the cupola furnace. So, we learn about the other furnaces which are there in your syllabus. So in last class, we have completed the cupola furnace and what is the type of raw material is used and how the total equipment is arranged and what is the type of temperature is going to be taken place in that one. So what is the different layers the raw material is to be get placed. So how the slag is to be get taken off, what are the different zones are going to be having and what is a melting zone and reducing zone and combustion zone. So what are the different zones are going to be having and what is the impurities and how the purities are to be get collected. So everything we have learned through the videos and everything. So the cupola furnace was completed. So in the last class, by we had totally completed what the different die castings are there. Here, so in this class, we will learn about what is meant by electric arc furnace. So we are having the another two, crucible furnace, electric arc furnace, and an induction furnace. So we are having a three parts. So we will learn about the electric arc furnace and how it is going to be. So how, what is the condition of that? So how the it is to be get arranged? So what is going to happen? Yeah. So in the electric arc furnace, so it is somewhat different compared to the other furnaces. So in the cupola furnace, we are mainly the furnace is to be to melt the metal. So how it is to be get arranged, that is the main thing is going to be considered. So electric arc furnace is different from the induction furnace. It is totally different from the induction furnace because in an induction furnace, the electric current is to be get passed and the material is to be get connected to the electric current. But here you are going to be using a different types of electrodes so that the electric current is passed towards the electrodes and these electrodes are dipped into the basin. So in the basin, it is made up of a refractory lining basin. So it is having a carbon bricks. It is made up of a carbon bricks. So for the, due to the current passing over to the basin, the raw material, whatever is to be get taken, it is to be get melted. Here, so and this electric arc furnace is mainly used for the steel making, the steel to melt the molten metal, to get the molten metal of a steel. So this electric arc furnace is mainly used. So the arrangement is also somewhat different compared to this the cupola furnace and as well as an induction furnace. Here, so in this one, the slag is to be get separated, the same what you had done in a cupola furnace, and as well as the purity is to be get separated. So it is taken into the lattice and it is to be get used in another part. So clear. So here the raw materials are used purely a slag. The raw materials, whatever it is used, it is a slag. So different raw materials, different scrap, where it is a combination of a pig iron or any other thing, it is to be get used. The raw materials. So and these raw materials it is in the form of a hot metal pig iron or a hot and cold DRI and a HPI. So it is a different percentages of the raw material. What is the leftover part? Leftover part that is to be get used here. And the total basin, whatever it is to be get taken, it is having some maximum amount of the thing. So the depends on the maximum amount of the basin to be get taken, the amount of the tons of the material is to be get poured, not the total thing is to be get poured. So amount of the total tons of the material is to be get poured. So the raw material, it is to be get collected from different areas. Different areas, 100% scrap, nothing is to get used here. It is 100% scrap. on different mixes of a hot metal, different mixes. It is not a only a pure iron or pig iron, only hot metal. It is not like that. It is a mixes of hot metal, pig iron, and hot and cold DRI and HBI. Clear? And this is, it is totally having a one bucket. So in the bucket, you are going to placing the total raw materials, and it is through the help of an electrodes, the current is to be get passed. And sometimes this electric arc furnace can be done in an automation type also, in an automation type. So in an automation, we are going to be guiding. So here, the these type of basins are there. You can collect the materials, and it is to be get poured into the bucket. And after that, the current is to be get passed from this way. So it is totally automation. How much the current is to be get given, how much voltage is to be get given. So how much minutes, how much time the total electrodes must be get dipped into the basket. So that is each and everything is the automation. So in present days, the electric arc furnace is mostly used. It is mostly used. But electric arc furnace, the disadvantage is it is very expensive. It is very expensive, and it cannot be used for a very small quantities. It is very expensive because the arrangement is typical. So the collection of the scrap is easy. It is an easy thing because the scrap only we are going to be getting. So the raw material is easy, but the arrangement of everything is to be get difficult. So it is a somewhat expensive. For that sake, some of the industries cannot be come forward to use the electric arc furnace. Clear? So the shortcut of electric arc furnace is, it is known as an EAF. It is electric arc furnace. So it is a furnace that heats charged material by means of an electric arc. And so by means of an electric arc, this total thing is to be get charged. So it comes to the arc furnace ranges in size from the small units of approximately 110 capacity. So here it explains that it is of a different sizes, arc furnace of the different size, whether it is a very big size or whether it is a very small size. Depends on the size, the material, the raw material is to be get carried over here. So when the scrap is to be get taken, so what is the density of the scrap? So the density of the scrap is normally less than 0.5 tons per meter cube. It is less than. And to heavy scrap, it is 1 ton. It is 1 ton capacity. So the arc furnace ranges in sizes from the small units of approximately 110 capacity used in foundries for producing the cast iron products. So up to the about 400 ton units used for a secondary steel making. So this is a perfect process which is used for a steel making thing. Clear? So next one. So the temperature range. So what is the temperature is to be get maintained for each and everything? Clear? For when the machine was to be get start. So what is the temperature is to be get maintained? So here the industrial electric arc furnace temperature can be up to 1800 degrees Celsius. It is can be up to 1800 degrees Celsius, while laboratory unit exceeds 3000 degrees Celsius. Here the industrial electric arc furnace temperatures can be up to 1800 degrees Celsius. It is nothing but 3272 Fahrenheit. Next, and while the laboratory units means in the labs, whatever is used. So it is up to 3000. So arc furnace differ from induction furnace. So as I had told you, it is differ from the induction furnace, because in an induction furnace, the material is directly charged. It is directly charged. But in this, the material is not directly charged. With the help of some electrodes, the electric energy is to be get passed over. It is not directly charged. So in the charge, in that charge, material is directly exposed to an electric arc. And the current in the furnace terminals passes through the charged material. And the next one. So what is the history? So where it was get started and when? So the first electric arc furnace were developed by the Paul Heriot of furnace of France. So with a commercial plant established in the United States in 1907. So it is mainly established there. So the Sanderson brothers, former the Sanderson Brothers Steel, cooperated in Syracuse, New York, installing the first electric arc furnace in the US. So this furnace is now on display at Station Square, Petersburg, Pennsylvania. So this is a place where the furnace is displayed, Station Square, Petersburg. So what are the different types of EAF? So we have to know what are the different types of EAF and what are the different types of electrodes are to be get used. Because you came to know that the current is to be get passed through the electrodes. So how the electrode is made up of? So the two kinds of electric current may be used in the electric arc furnace. One is a direct EAF, direct current, DC current. The second one is alternating current, AC current, it is EAF. So the three-phase AC electric arc furnace with a graphite electrodes are commonly used in a steel making. So the main thing is three-phase AC current with the graphite electrodes are mainly used in a steel making. So the construction, how the construction is? So the construction is you are be having a bottom, it is in a spherical hearth and a cylindrical shell and a swinging water cool dome shaped roof. So it is having a spherical part, it is in a cylindrical shape. It is in a cylindrical shape which is placed on some dome. So the total cylindrical shape is to be having a refractory lining made up of a carbon brick. So the roof has a three holes. So after the cylindrical shell, the top of the cylindrical shell is to be closed with some dome. So the dome is having a three holes where the electrodes are to be get placed. Where the electrodes are to be get placed and as well as those electrodes are to be get charged, which is connected to the electric furnace. So the roof has a three holes for consumable graphite electrodes held by a clamping mechanism, held by the clamping mechanism. So the mechanism provides independent lifting and lowering of an each electrode. Clear? So the water cooled electrode holders serve also as a contacts for the transmitting electric current supplied by the water cooled cables. So before reading this one, we will see what is the diagram. Yeah, this is the diagram. Can you see, students? This is the diagram. This is the shape, cylindrical shape, which is going to be having. So it is collected the both the slag and as well as the purity, the molten metal and as well as the slag. So the slag is totally covered to the molten metal. Whatever the pure molten metal is to be get collected, it is totally having the slag, not only one type of place or one type of area. It is totally in all the corners, the slag is to be get there. So firstly, the slag is to be get removed. And after that, the molten metal is to be get removed. Clear? So these are the electrodes which are made up of a graphite, which are made up of a graphite. And these electrodes are placed in such a manner, the top dome is having a three holes. It is having a three holes. And these electrodes are placed by using a clamping mechanism. And these electrodes are connected to a furnace. It is connected to some power, some electric power, where the current is to be get passed. So from when the switch is on, these electrodes will be get vibrates, the arc is to be get produced. It is vibrate, the arc is to be get produced, and the material, the raw material, the scrap what you have get taken through the electrodes, the scrap totally get melts. And after that it is formed the slag and as well as a molten metal. So the thing is, it is to be get removed. The thing is, it is to be get removed. The slag is to be get removed. So in the electric arc furnace, there is a point that there is some wastage of the molten metal also. Molten metal also, because it is not in the design shape of a cupola furnace. Because in a cupola furnace, you had seen there is a slag hole and as well as a tap hole. So in a tap hole, you are collecting the purity. In a slag hole, you are collecting the impurity. So the slag hole is designed in a shape, in an inclined shape. So there you are going to be separating directly. But here there is a chance of taking some of the molten metal towards the slag hole also. Because here the total mechanism is tilting. The total body is tilting. It is not having some type of inclined shapes or any other thing. So the total machine is to be get tilted. So for that sake, some amount of molten metal can also be get waste. Clear? So the one from one door, the slag is to be get removed from another door, the molten metal is to be get removed. Okay, so this is the total diagram construction, how it is going to be there. Okay, so now we will see what are the different points. So the electrode and a scrap from the star connection of a three phase current, in which the scrap is common junction. The scrap is a common junction. So the three phase current is to be get taken. So the furnace is mounted on a tilting mechanism. So as I had told you, the furnace is tilting mechanism. It is not a fixed part. So the cupola furnace is a fixed. It is not to be get moved from one place to another place. But the furnace, whatever it is to be taken under electric, so it is having some tilting, some oscillating mechanism it is having. So it is fixed only the edges, not the total part. Clear? So the furnace is mounted on a tilting mechanism for tapping the molten metal through a tap hole with a pore spout located on the back side of the shell. Clear? So the charge door through which the slag components and alloying additives are charged and is located on the front side of the furnace shell. So the charge door is to be there for the total cylindrical shell, from where the amount of material is to be get taken and from which the slag is to be get removed. So everything is to be get happen. So in this, the three stages will be get there. The first one is a melting, the second one is oxidizing, the third one is a reducing zone. So the three stages is going to be happen. And so the next point is the charge door is also used for removing the slag. So as I had told you, the charge door is used to take in over, to add some of the additives, to add some of the materials from the scrap, whatever the scrap you are going to be using, to add the raw materials into the cylindrical shell. At the same time, the charge door is used for removing the slag also. So for the three cases, this charge door is to be it used. So this is the diagram what you had seen. So refractory lining. So I had told you the refractory lining, the cylindrical shell is made up of a carbon brick. It is made up of a carbon brick. So the refractory linings of an electric arc furnace are made generally of resin bonded magnesia carbon bricks. So this the total cylindrical shell is made up of this part. So when the bricks are heated, the bonding material is cooked and the turns into a carbon network binding, the refractory grains. So when it is to be get start heating, so when the current is to, the three phase current is to be passed through the electrodes, so what is going to be happening for the refractory lining? So when the total material, when the total shell is to be get heating, so whatever the resin bonded magnesia carbon bricks was attached to it, it is having some bonding nature. It is having some bonding nature. So it preventing wetting by the slag and protecting the lining, the erosion and the chemical attack of the molten metal and the slag. So due to this one, so whatever the collection, the molten metal and the slag is going to be happen, the other type of chemical attacks cannot be get occurred. Other type of thing, maybe it is in some type of impurities or any other type of gases or any other type of wastage, it cannot be get attacked for the inner part, for the molten metal which is to be carried out. Clear? So the next one. So operation and working. So the scrap is charged commonly from the furnace top, as I had told you. So the roof with the electrodes is swung aside before the scrap charging. So the scrap arranged in the charge basket is transferred to the furnace by a crane and then dropped into the shell. So the first one is the top of the top is to be get placed to a total cylindrical shell, and the top dome is going to be having a three holes from where the electrodes is to be get carrying over. So those electrodes are connected to the three phase current from where the current is to be get pass over. So these electrodes are dipped into the cylindrical shell. So when the current passes through the electrodes, the it is to be get vibrates and some arc is to be get produced, so that the raw material, whatever is to be get taken, it is starts melting. So the scrap is arranged in the charge basket. So beforely the scrap, whatever is to be get taken, it is to be get arranged through the charging door. Clear? So the next one. So the lower voltages are selected for this first part of the operation to protect the roof and walls from the excessive heat and damage from the arcs. So here, the not the high voltage, a small voltage is enough, so that the total arrangement of your electric arc furnace cannot be get damaged, so that the total machine will be having a good nature. So once the electrodes have reached the heavy melt at the base of the furnace, and the arcs are shielded by the scrap, and the arcs are shielded by the scrap. So as I had told, when the electrodes are having some charging, so what it happens, automatically the material starts melting. So the scrap is to be get shielded. The arcs are to be get shielded by the scrap. So arcs are to be get produced. So the voltage can be increased and the electrodes raised slightly. So lightening the arcs and increasing the power to the melt. Yeah. So next. So before seeing what is going to be happening, the what is the melting and oxidizing and reducing, we will see the video how it is going to be happen. Clear? So this is the electric arc furnace. So as I had told you, so this is the base. It is a cylindrical shell. So can you observe, students? The cylindrical shell is in a place can be get tilted. So it is made up of a refractory lining, magnesia, carbon bricks. So in this, the scrap is to be get taken in a small quantity, in a small size, not a big grain size. So the top dome is to be get placed. And the dome is having a three holes where the electrodes are to be get taken. So this yellow color is shows that it is an electrode. Those are the electrodes which are made up of a graphite. So this electrodes are placed in form of a some mechanism, clamping mechanism. So for this one, the current is to be get passed. Okay. So when the current is to be get passed, the material starts melting. Its raw material gets starts melting, and after the thing, from this point, the molten metal is to be get carried over. So we will see the another thing where I had told you it is an automation electric furnace was there. So I will show that point. See, this is a video what they had displayed from the steeluniversity.org. So this is the total machine. So they are going to be selecting from the, it is an automation electric machine. So it is not directly taken. So here, how much type of material is to be get taken? So you can see here, students. So what is the type of material? Number one, heavy. Number one, two. So isothermal, low alloyed, plate and structure. Number one, bundles, and number two, bundles. Direct reduced iron. Shredded, turnings, and EAF dust. So what is the type of raw material is used here? So which material is to be get selected? So this is totally an automation thing. It is not done purely in an outside. It is not a mankind. It is an automation thing. So the electric furnace here, the machine is totally operated by some computer. Clear? So the beside to the raw material, they had given a unit cost also. So what is the unit cost per one ton? So what is the mass? So how much mass is to be taken for each and everything? So on the other side, they had given a volume and a cost, and a please select a target steel grade. So what is the steel grade you are going to be required? So what type of steel? So what are the type of grades you are going to be having? So what is the type of element it is going to be taken? So here they had taken a plate and a structural. So they had taken a mass of 30. So automatically the cost is to be get changed at 8,700. And when the plate and a structural was taken, these are the elements which are going to be occurred. The carbon, silicon, manganese, phosphorus, sulfur, chromium, magnesium, nickel. So these are the things which are going to be occur when the plate and a structural is going to be taken. Next, number one, bundles. So number one bundles, it is of mass 30, volume is 25, and 6,400 cost. So when this is taken, the titanium is to be get occurred, and as well as the NB and N material itself. So number two material. So when it is a combination of the different scraps, so here, when it is a combination of different scraps, the material elements, whatever it is going to be taken, it is to be get changes. So at the same time, you can see here what is a flow chart. In the flow chart, what are the different elements are there, and how much quantity, what is the mass percentage is to be get taken, how much percentage of each and everything is to be get comes out from it. So you can observe this also. So at the same time, you can observe what is the total cost, what is the total mass quantity, what is the volume, and what is the total cost. So mass quantity is compulsory because it depends on the size of the mold machine which is going to be taken. So all the cylindrical shells cannot be carried out a more number of tons. So depends on the cylindrical shell, the material is to be taken. So after that, they are going to be selecting. So you can see here, what is a scrap yard? Scrap bins, the number one heavy, number one two. So these are the different bins where the number one bundles, in this one, it is to be get taken. So you can observe that plate and a structure. So in the first page, you have selected, that is the number of tons I want to get selected. And number one bundle, you had selected 30 tons. And number two bundles, 30. So in the second page, you are going to be getting, these are the materials to be get selected. Clear? So in the scrap basket, here they had given three baskets, one over the other. So in the first basket, how much mass it is to be get taken over. In the second, how much, and the third, how much it is to be get collected. So the first one, so this is the first one, plate and a structural. So it is selected, and the second part, the quantity is 30. So the 30 is selected, and the third one, it is number of bundles. So this is the machine, students. It is an automatic machine. You can see in your computer. So what is the simulation rate? They had given what is the elapsed time and what is the liquid steel temperature. So what is the relative power and the power water cooling presence. So these are the things were there. So here you can observe, there are the three ladles. You can observe there are three ladles, one over the other. So in the first ladle, you had seen that there are two different types of raw materials was collected and mixed. So one is a pure and a structural. The second one is a number one bundles. So number one bundle is nothing but one type of scrap is to be get there. It was stored there. So number two, it is one type of scrap is to be get stored. Clear? So after that, so simulation rate, so they had started the total machine, how much time is to be get taken. So the first one, the scrap is to be get collected. So the dome is to be closed, and after that the electrodes are to be get into the cylindrical shell. So the current is to be get passed, and whatever the material is taken, it is charged. Next, after that, second shell is taken, the machine is stopped. So the first metal, whatever the raw material you had taken, it is starting melting. So the material is to be reducing there. So then the electrodes are passing over to the material. So you can observe here, students, some of the molten metal is started, some of the molten metal. So after completion of this one, it is to be get removed. And next, from the second ladle, again the raw material is to be taken. And after that, again the dome is to be get closed. Again the electrodes start charging. So after having a charge, the molten metal is to be get collected there. So what is the carbon flow and what is an oxygen flow you are going to be taken over. So what is the water cooling level also we are going to be taken consider. So after the total thing was melted, the slag and as well as the purity molten metal is to be taken over. So now the dome is to be open and the molten metal is to be taken into the ladles. Clear, students? So this is nothing but an automation. Actually, it is going to be carried out in backside of this part. So you are going to be observing in a system. Okay, this tire, the machine is going to be happening. This is the minute. At this point, the machine is going to be doing this operation. So we can observe in the system. So here the summary of the result. So here the summary of result explains that what is the final steel composition. So what is the final steel composition, final slag composition? So I had told you the slag is separated and the molten metal steel is to be get separated. So they had given the simulation settings. So it is successfully say or not. So whatever the thing you had completed, you will get some result whether you had get a certain amount of molten metal there or not. So what is the final steel composition? When you click the analysis, you will get what is the content was there. So final slag composition, when you click on this one, you will get what is going to be there. So what is the total time? So it is 1 hour, 20 minutes, the target is. Actually, it was taken 53. So the tap temperature, it is, the target is 1630 to 1660 degrees Celsius. And it is the actual was 1640. So what is the tapping mass? So what is the electrical energy? So how much electrical energy, what is the current is to be get passed? Okay, so here in the bottom, they had also given what is the cost, what is the power, what is the scrap, what is the additives which are going to be taken. So what is the other consumables? So totally, this is the total cost for your certain molten metal in an electric arc furnace. Clear, students? So this is the how the electric arc furnace is going to be happening when it is an automation thing was going to be taken. Okay, so in next one, so I think you had got some point how the EAF is to be get carried over, whether it is in both, one is a mankind and another is an automation. So here the chemical and a physical process in an EAF. So the first one is melting. So melting process starts at a low voltage, short arc between the electrodes and the scrap. The arc during this period is unstable. So in order to improve the arc stability, small pieces of the scrap are placed in the upper layer of the charge. So the electrodes descend, melting the charge and penetrating into the scrap formation bores. Okay, so what is going to be taken? So the next one is the molten metal flows down to the furnace bottom. So when the electrodes reach the liquid bath, the arc becomes stable and the voltage may be increased. Next one is the electrodes are lifting together with the melt level. Most of the scrap, 80%, 85% melt during this period. So when the thing was going to be happen, 85% of the scrap can be get melted. So temperature of the arc reaches to 6300 degrees Celsius. So 15% of the thing, it can be formed as a slag, I think so. So the oxidizing stage. So at the stage of the excessive carbon, phosphorus, silicon and manganese oxide, the process is similar to that in a basic oxygen furnace. So you have seen in the steel organization university. So there you have seen it is a selection of the material, the scrap material, whatever different types of things are going to be occurred, different types of elements are to be get occurred. So carbon, phosphorus, silicon, manganese, titanium, you have seen a different part. So these are the elements which are can be get oxidized. So the process is similar to that of basic oxygen furnace. So the basic oxidizing slag composed of lime and iron ore is used during the oxidizing period. So gaseous oxygen may be blown into the melt for additional oxidizing. Yes, friends. So here the basic oxidizing slag composed of a lime and an iron ore. Okay. So the next one is reducing stage. So the first one, the melting, the second one is oxidizing, and the third one is a reducer. So the in a reducing stage, the new slag composed mainly of a lime. So whatever the slag is to be get taken over, it is composed of composition of a lime and a slag fluidizer. It is a CaF2. It is added to this stage for formation of a basic reducing conditions. Okay, so the function of the slag is refining of the steel from sulfur and absorption of the oxides. So formed as a result of deoxidization. So when this type of thing is to be get taken, so it is absorbed of the oxides, and as a result, it is formed as deoxidization. It is killing. So whatever the excess, the chemical attacks are going to be happening for the total molten metal, it is to be, it starts deoxidizing. So the excessive oxygen dissolved in the melt during the oxidizing period is removed by the metallic deoxidizers. So these are the three reactions which is to be get carried over. So now when the manganese, so what the manganese element is to be get produced. So when the manganese was to be get taken, when the oxidizing is to be get happening, manganese plus oxygen, manganese oxide, silicon plus dioxide, silicon dioxide. So aluminium plus oxygen, you will getting as aluminium trioxide. So next one is the basic reducing slag is favorable for desulfurization in accordance to the reaction. So you have seen in a video different types of elements, carbon, manganese, titanium, sulfur, phosphorus, nickel, magnesium. So different types of elements are going to be get start occurring. So when the sulfur is to be having the reaction, when the sulfur is added for the lime, so we are going to be getting the calcium sulfide plus oxide. Clear? So this is the reaction taking place. So next, the similarly iron oxide causes the increase of the oxygen content in the molten metal according to the reaction. Ferrous oxide, ferrous plus oxygen. So again, the same related to the carbon, carbon plus oxygen, carbon oxide, silicon plus oxide, silicon dioxide, manganese plus oxygen, manganese dioxide, and next phosphorus plus oxygen, P2O5. So the carbon monoxide partially burns in the atmosphere. So it is carbon monoxide plus oxygen, carbon dioxide. So these are the things which are elements which is going to be getting over. So some of the things are burning in the atmosphere. So the advantages comes over to the advantages. The use of the EAF all allows the steel to be made from a 100% scrap. So I had told you it is made up of a purely scrap material. Nothing raw material is to be get by it. It is a wastage of the material. From that you are preparing a steel. So this greatly reduces the energy required to make a steel when compared with primary steel making from ores. Okay, so another benefit is flexibility. While blast furnace cannot vary their production by much and can remain in operation for years at a time. Okay, so next one. So EAFs can be rapidly started and stopped, allowing the steel mill in vary production according to the demand. So it can be get starts and it can be get stops. So as we had seen, it is the first technique used in a USA. So although the steel making furnace generally uses scrap steel as a primary thing, scrap steel, steel is a primary thing, which is a combination of a pig iron, hot metal, or any other direct heat material or any other thing. So we will see the, what is the environmental issues are getting when the electric furnace is going to be taken, carried over. So although the modern electric arc furnace is a highly efficient recycler of steel scrap, operation of an arc furnace shop can have adverse environmental effects. Much of the capital cost of the new installation will be devoted to the systems intended to reduce these effects, which include: one is enclosures to reduce the high sound levels. The second is dust collector from furnace of gas The third is a slag production, cooling water demand, heavy truck traffic for scrap material handling and a product. So there is some thing related to the scrap carrying and how it is to be get handled. So environmental effects of electricity generation. It must be having some inverters or any other generators, high generators, so that the machine cannot be get stopped. So how much electricity is to be get used also. So because of the very dynamic quality of the arc furnace load, power systems may require technical measures to maintain the quality of power for other customers. So flicker and harmonic distortion are common side effects of a arc furnace operation on a power system. So these are the, some of the environmental issues when it can be taken as some of the disadvantages also. Some of the disadvantages when the electric arc furnace is to be taken over. So one can be high sound levels, it can be reduced high sound levels and dust collector for a furnace of gas, slag production, cooling water demand, because continuously the work is to be get taken over, so the machine is to be get cooled. So the there is a material handling equipment is to be get taken to how to the scrap is to be get carried over and how the materials are to be, how the molten metal is to be get carried over and how the electricity is to be the three phase current. So when three phase current is to be get taken, the current, the power supply must be get constant. So we have to check whether the generator is taken or any other source to have a power. So because of the very dynamic quality of the arc furnace load, power systems, the technical measures to maintain the quality of the power. So these are the main thing which is going to be under the electric arc furnace. Okay, students. So we have to, so with this you can learn. So what is going to be happening? So this material is enough to learn what is going to be happening in electric arc furnace, what is the different raw materials to be get used. So what are the different elements get starting oxidized and deoxidized. So what are the different zones are to be get carried over. So these are the things happening in electric arc furnace. Yeah. So in the next class, we will learn about what is a crucible furnace. What is a crucible furnace and what is an induction furnace. I think this is induction furnace and you had one of the, in a second year from a production technology subject, I think, induction furnace. So we will be having some of the revision over the induction furnace. So it is directly the material starts electrified. The current is directly passed over to the material. The current, electricity current is directly passed over to the material. But in an electric arc furnace, the electricity is not directly passed over to the material. It is not directly having a contact here. So with this, so in the second unit, we can get a complete what are the different types of furnaces. So we had also learned about the selection of the casting process, general, we didn't start, I think, the general design considerations for the casting. So we had completed up to the selection of the casting process. And we are learning what are the different types of furnaces are to be get used. Okay. So we will learn in the next class what are the design considerations in a casting process. Okay.